Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Rogers Kakasungura YouTube channel. A big thank you for your continued support. There is a family I shared in my previous videos, a total orphan who lives alone in the forest. After his parents died, he ran away back home from the Luya land Kakamega, where they were working. He ran back to the village and is trying life na hana nyumba hata kidogo. We visited that family today and I'm asking God to help us. Tumsaidie kumjengea nyumba, at least yakuwe na mahali anaita nyumbani. Tulimtembelea leo, is living in a miserable life and our work away from politics is to change lives. So Mungu akuzungumzie kwa moyo wa upendo, kwa moyo wa unyenyekevu. Tunatafuta mabati 32. I've already received 10 iron sheets, so tumebakisha 22. Tunataka milango, dirisha. I will be giving you a breakdown of the items so that you pick which that suits you. But as of now, wacha kwanza tubate mabati. Mabati moja paka transport ni 1350. So mabati 22 tabiga hesabu jue ni ngapi, ni pia mabati 5, mabati 10, mabati 2, mabati 1. Or you can provide the 22 iron sheets at once and God will highly bless you abundantly. Ni maisha magumu kaka. Kuna mtu ambaye alipitia maisha kama haya and you can really understand what I'm talking about. So wacha Mungu akuzungumzie, tuungane pamoja so that tusaidie huyu jamaa kuna watoto apate mahali pa kuishi ili mvua isije ikawamaliza kama familia. I have a video here I want to share with you. The video is heated demonstrations and they were happening in Eldoret in the course of this week. Maandamano makubwa yalifanyika na the locals were protesting against the poor road network and they were asking the president kwamba huko nyumbani ni kwao, wanazungumza lugha moja tuguluche muge, and they are saying walipigia president kura lakini amewa abandon, wanapitia maisha magumu. The border borders are unable to make their way home. The vehicles are unable to make their way home. And even when someone is sick, they are unable to effectively, on time, transport that person to the hospital. So they are raising concerns and saying, sisi tuko ndani ya serikali kama wakalenjin, lakini barabara ambazo tunazo ni barabara mbaya zaidi, na sisi tulipigia viongozi kura kwa matarajio kwamba they are going to give us development, lakini sasa wametuacha kwa mata. One person in that video is boldly asking the president kwamba William Ruto tulikupigia kura kama mtoto wetu, mbona unatuacha tunateseka in such an environment? So can you watch this video in 1 minute, then I'll come back.
Kama hii barabara itatengenezwa, hatutatoa hii ndizi kwa sababu hii barabara ni shamba, si barabara. Na imekuwa mara mingi watoto wa shule wanaanguka, magari ya shule wanakoa baba.
Very soon itakuwa city, itakuwaje city na hapa ni matope. Siku ya leo tumeamua kwamba tunataka tujue barabara ni ya nani. Hii barabara ni ya county, ni ya kera, ama ni nani? Sababu tunaambiwa ni MP, ni county mpaka hata MCA. Wewe brosa uko wapi? Wewe brosa uko wapi kweli? Tulikupigia kura. Kwa nini kweli? Mateso ni nini? Na hapa ni nyumbani. Hapa ni area yako kweli kweli. Unatusaidia aje?
Simo na boda boda. Tunateseka kutosha bana.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is not Photoshop. Umesikia vile wanazungumza wao wenyewe. But then, why do we vote as a people? Kwa nini unapiga kura kama Mkenya? Why do you wake up early in the morning? You go queue the whole day casting votes for somebody. Why? What pushes you out of your bed early in the morning to go and elect someone? Ni nini kile kinakusukuma kutoka ndani? I have a few reasons why we vote. One, and which is the major, is an opportunity for change. We vote because we have been constitutionally given an opportunity to make a change within our community. Which change is this? Making a positive impact within our community. You hear someone says, nataka kwenda kupiga kura ili tutengenezewe barabara. Nataka kwenda kupiga kura tumchague mtu ambaye anatusikiza kama wa Kenya, atujengee shule. You hear men and women in villages say, we want to, this time round, tunataka kubadilisha uongozi. Kipita kwa wazee unasikia, this time round, tunaenda kwa ballot. Na huyo kiongozi atatutambua. So people vote because they want good education for themselves and their children. People vote because they want good roads within their localities. People vote because they want good hospitals. They want good health infrastructures. They want medicine in hospitals. That's why people vote. People vote because they want good infrastructure, to be precise. People want to vote because they want electricity. You've heard men and women say in those villages, huyu kiongozi tuko naye amekataa kutujengea barabara. So, tunamungoja. Tukifika kwa ballot, we are voting him out. Why? Because that leader may be failed to provide good road networks. An area with good road networks brings development. Roads makes a place to grow. Roads expand places. Why? Passable roads can make you reach hospital fast. It can make you reach the market fast. It can make you sell your goods fast. So, barabara is everything. Minus a road, you can't access the market. Minus a good road, you can't access a school. Minus a good road, you cannot access a hospital. Minus a good road, you cannot transport your goods to the market on time. So, good roads is a foundation of every development within a community. And that is a fact. Go to places with poor roads. They don't grow. They remain remote for ages. That is why, as leaders, a good leader fights to bring change in his locality. If you are a member of parliament and you have been elected, you fight to bring change within your constituency. If you are an MCA, you fight to bring change in your respective wards. If you are a governor, you fight to bring change within your county. Now, juicy too, Eldoret produced a CS for roads who served for like 20 months in office. When that CS was dismissed, I saw the very same people in Eldoret holding maandamano, asking why their CS, who was dismissed, has not been renominated when William Ruto announced the first batch of cabinet secretaries. They were defending Kipchumba Murkomen, their son, as they were saying, a minister for roads. But today, the very same people are protesting against poor road network. Aukunipata vizuri. The region voted for their president, William Ruto. Yemune, wakasema freedom has come, tunataka kijana yetu. Sawa. The very same people walikuwa na kijana yao as the minister of roads. Ambaye anaitwa Kipchumba Murkomen. In 20 months, Kipchumba Murkomen never remembered the road they are protesting for. Hii barabara wanaandamania kuikumbuka. Wakati alitolewa, wanaandamana kwa nini mtoto wetu ametolewa. I think you saw those demos. And I showed you here. The very same people now, they are again protesting against poor road network. Ujinga uko Kenya hii. Hey! I don't know whether one day wa Kenya tutaerevuka tutae ujinga. Ndio maana we keep making mistakes during elections. God bless you, ladies and gentlemen. See you in the next video. Asanteni sana.